So what are we doing today?
We're going to Shady Maples to reward the kids for just being kids, to give them a reminder why they're kids, because we just got out of the hospital after 18 days, and we wanted to make sure that, you know, we do something fun after we do big, you know, big hospitalizations and things like that. Started at 5:30 this morning with Samaya waking us up with a seizure and not breathing. Went into a 2.5 hour bath, medicine, treatment routine. We had to do breakfast, then we had to get all their stuff packed, which is like Ambu bags, oxygen, diaper bags with extra medicine.
We gotta carry Samaya's bag.
Yep, we gotta carry Samaya's bag, you're right.
Then we had to load them up in the van, which is a process in itself. We live on a hill, and so normally we go across my mom's yard, down a hill, across an alleyway to get them into the van. But today it was all muddy, so we had to go and run them down a hill and down steps, that sort of thing, to get them into the van. But the good news is it only took us like 2.5-3 hours, which was a pretty good accomplishment for us. Samaya has hydrocephalus, which means water collects on her brain. She has a little tube that goes from her brain down into her heart to alleviate the fluid that builds up on her brain. She also has a pretty severe seizure disorder. And from being so premature, her lungs have a lot of damage to them. So she catches respiratory illnesses really quickly. She is just an amazing little thing. She's very, very determined to do things and very observant of everything that goes on in the house. The smile, I mean, you get one of her smiles and you're like done for the day.
Who's the cook in your family?
Not me. Not me. Anyone else?
My Siley is an amazing kid. She's graduated from college now. She is my backup whenever I'm not here. Sally, we adopted from India, and she was born without parts of her legs and her arms. She's got a lot of congenital anomalies. She was born without a tongue. She doesn't let that stop her at all. Like, she's totally takes care of herself and does everything very independently. There's not going to be anything stopping her. Nothing will ever stop my Sally.
You got it? Well, I'm not going to carry it. If you want it, you got to hold it.
It's a baby. It's a baby.
You got to hold it.
It's a baby.
You got her. Don't let her fall.
Can't touch her tail.
You can touch anything you want to touch.
He's just a funny little kid. You know, everything is just funny to him. And he has what I call boy humor, which means pretty much any bodily function, we will announce to the world that we have done this and that it needs taken care of. So burping, farting, all that fun stuff. Brian, we got when he was 1 month old. He has a diagnosis of Duchenne's muscular dystrophy, adrenal hypoplasia, and something called complex glycokinase deficiency. The combination's pretty much unheard of. Our children were diagnosed. There was only two other kids that they knew of. One was Brian's half-brother, Charlie. Because of the Duchenne's, weakens all of your muscles slowly until it breaks down all of the muscles in his body. So at one point, Brian's going to end up needing trach and on a ventilator. The diagnosis is terminal. His life expectancy is like 20 years old if it goes the way it went with his brother. My Charlie boy we got when he was 3 months old. He has the same diagnoses. Charlie's pure happiness. Even as a baby, nothing would make him upset. We were able to keep him out of the hospital most of his life, which was amazing and wonderful. But he was always on the verge of being sick. We always had to be careful of what we did with Charlie. And we are that way with all of our kids. You can't just take them out every day. You can't just run here or there. You always got to watch if anybody's sick around them, or if anybody is, you know, if you've out too long. Like Charlie loved to swim, but you couldn't let him in the swimming pool too long because he'd burn up the muscles. And it would make him sick if he was in the pool too long. Charlie just was an amazing kid. He loved chickens. Chickens were huge. His absolute favorite thing in the world was wrestling and Incredible Hulk. My payoff of my kid with my kids is their smiles, the way they hug me. And even when they can't hug me, the way I hug them and they smile from that, you know, that they know that they're loved and they know that I'll do anything for them. I mean, I would even give up myself for one more day for him. But we had to let him go in August. And God has him now.
It was a blur, wasn't it?
How did it go?
It went excellent. The kids got everything they wanted and more. Do his pit stop so it gives John time to get home with the other kids and start getting them unloaded so nobody's sitting in the cold. We stopped at Spring Glen Factory Outlet to get homemade pot pie because I don't make homemade pot pie. And it's not homemade chicken pie. It's homemade pot pie with bowling noodles, Lancaster County style. Best thing ever, unless you're going to cook it yourself. Joshua!
What's happening back here?
Say, excuse me. He is all boy, that's all I'm saying.
What I'm gonna be doing is a Theravest on her. It's gonna shake her to where whatever's in the lungs, if there's anything, which I don't hear anything, that helps bring it up. So don't stay in one position. And does its work?
Time.
Joshua, he's my little fireball. Joshua, we got at 1 month old. He weighed 4 pounds and he was the tiniest little thing. And it broke my heart. Because here's this poor little baby with nobody in this world. I couldn't leave him. And he's been my sidekick ever since. His pain level is really high. He has a double chromosome. He has fetal alcohol syndrome. He has lesions on his white brain matter, which causes him to have seizures. He has tracheomalacia, and that's why he has a trach. His lungs, I don't even know how his lungs work. He has so much damage to his lungs, and that's why we were just in the hospital. The COVID ended up turning into a few other things, and we bought an 18-day stay here at Hershey at the ICU, where he got vented and he ended up with a chest tube. He's slowly fighting his way back.
Ready?
He has taken hit after hit after hit medically. On the good days, though, he is sunshine. He is the biggest smile and the biggest lovey kid, and so good at cuddling. I have another child named Malik. He's 18 years old right now. He was in and out of the hospital all of his life. Only short visits, usually because of asthma and respiratory issues. He's kind of a quiet kid and he's kind of an introvert, so he's not really on a whole lot of our videos, but it's important to mention him. But he's doing really well right now and he's becoming quite the young man. When you're at home with these kids, it's me standing between them all. I'm the one that has to bag my own child to make it breathe. Without that meal, especially the first 2 or 3 days until my home life gets straightened out, that's the meal I get. And I'm very thankful, and I very much appreciate that meal, because it's hot, and it gets you through the next 24 hours at least. Cannot say enough about the Hummingbird program. They're my heart. They were irreplaceable during Charlie's end of time. They called me weekly. The last couple of weeks, it was daily, just to see what I needed, how we can make Charlie more comfortable. And when we're in the hospital, they are the go-between me and the doctors. And then there's Child Life. We love Child Life. Child Life saves me so many times, especially when I get in the middle of the night call runs to the hospital and you don't even have a single toy in that bag for some reason. They will find me toys. They will find me coloring books, whatever it is to occupy ER visits, hospital visits, in-house visits, day surgery. I mean, Child Life is everywhere. Hospitalizations for children are hard, and it takes a lot of their childhood away from them. Children's Miracle Network gives that childhood back. Somewhere in there, as long as a person has a heartbeat, as long as a person has the ability to be still on this earth, there is a spirit in there, and there is somebody in there that needs to be loved, and there's somebody in there that needs to be talked to. And that's why we do it, because these kids can't. Somebody needs to stand up for these kids. Somebody needs to love these kids. And I will continue to do it. As long as God gives me breath, I will continue to fight for them.